Hi friends, Principal Rabb-Patterson here on this September 4th. Let's find out what's going on in Chapter 3 with writing chants. Chapter 3. We live on a block of row houses with big front porches. Some of the houses are messed up like the boarded up ones. They make everything look mean. There aren't that many trees to hide the bad looking houses either. When we were little, me and Foster used to jump the banisters and work our way down the street without ever touching the sidewalk. The sidewalk's where stuff happens. Somebody got shot out there last summer, and there's always a bunch of guys hanging on the corner. Some of them are looking for work, some ain't no good, some just ran out of juice. The thing is, you gotta figure out which is which. We were over at Foster's house playing cards after the first day at the stables. So, what's on your mind? Foster asked. Asked me what I thought about stuff before I had a chance to ask him. We were sitting on the floor, leaning against his bed. Something about that day made me feel better. My chest felt open like the thunder from the galloping horses stirred something up. The horses were sweet, but I don't like that dude Winston. Sweet, phew. Are we talking about the same place? I knew what he was saying. Being the horse janitor wasn't going to be fun. This was May and it smelled bad already. And did you see those polo dudes out on the field? They look tougher than the football team over at Dunhill. Foster picks up on everything. Pop says he's a perceptive young man, a good friend to have. Yeah, the polo thing, I said. How come nobody ever heard of it? Miss T said it used to be just for rich people. Miss T is Foster's mom. She's all right with me. She and Foster really helped me out when my mom passed, when I was upside down. Well, I said, I don't know about you, but like it or not, I have to stick with it. We both knew I might get expelled if I didn't. Foster skips school sometimes, but not as much as me. He put the cards down and looked at me with one eyebrow raised. They beat people up over at Dunhill. Dunhill High School, where I'd end up. I didn't want Foster to keep talking about it. I squeezed my eyes shut. Smells like Mrs. T's getting busy downstairs, I said. The smell of her chicken gumbo made its way up to Foster's room. It was probably dinner time at my house, too. It's time to eat, man. I got up off the floor. Check you out tomorrow. I picked up my backpack and headed downstairs. I struck my head in their kitchen and waved to Miss T before I left. The block was quiet. Most people were inside their houses, everybody but Lele. He was leaning on a car across the street. We hadn't spoken since the iPhone thing went down. Best to just keep walking. I knew Pop's brother, Uncle Ronnie, was over the house when I saw his motorcycle parked up on the sidewalk right next to Mr. Glover's TV. Guess he figured Mr. Glover couldn't keep but an eye on his bike while he watched his shows. Uncle Ronnie lit things up when he came over. He was on me soon as I walked into the living room. Hey, little man, you keeping busy? He leaned forward in the reclining chair. How's the ladies treating you? Not as good as you, Uncle Ronnie. I know that's right, he said, settling back. Uncle Ronnie had on his cowboy boots and leather hat. He was always worried about how he looked. Not like Pops. Pops could have looked better, but he didn't care. For God's sake, Ron, will you give it a break? You've been asking folks that for years. Pop's been tired of Uncle Ronnie's ladies' man routine. Pops picked up the remote and turned off the TV. You know I taught you better than that. Real men respect women, a voice said. Ooh, Grandma. Uncle Ronnie busted big time. Didn't nobody know she could hear everything from the other room. Grandma came to live with us after my mom passed. Pops took that real hard. He still wasn't right from it. How much did you hear? Asked Uncle Ronnie. Enough, said Grandma. She stepped from the kitchen doorway into the small dining room where the table was set. We can eat as soon as Ronnie takes his hat off. The skin on her face and neck was shiny with sweat. Uncle Ronnie did what Grandma said. I ain't trying to disrespect nobody. He winked at me in the split second before his hat covered his face. Ain't, said Grandma, shaking her head. She put the fried fish on the table. We all sat down and Pops changed the subject before Uncle Ronnie sat Grandma off again. So, how's things in the park? I made a quick calculation. Do I play it cool or tell it straight? All right, I said, going for cool. All right, is that all you have to say? Pops pointed at the coleslaw, asking Uncle Ronnie to pass it up to him. I wish I had had the chance to work with horses when I was your age. Grandma reached over and patted my hand. This is a good thing, Troy. We don't want you to end up like some of these other young men around here. I wasn't in the mood for a lecture. I needed time to think about stuff on my own. I could like the horses, but I was scared of them. Didn't know what Winston was going to be like. Still wasn't sure what polo even was. It wasn't basketball. Wasn't football. Wasn't boxing. Wasn't nothing I knew. Dre wasn't bad, but I didn't really want to be all the horsey like him. That girl was fly, though. Pops used to talk to me about girls, you know, how to act when you go over to a girl's house and how they want to be treated, but he didn't feel like talking much right now. And the other animals were another thing, goats and all of that. They were totally new to me. We never had a cat or nothing. Pop said they would have been just another mouth to feed. The only animals I knew were some bad dogs around the way that I did my best to stay away from. Like I said, I was scared of the horses, but I wasn't telling nobody. Man, their flow was tight. They were beautiful, all power, prancing around the yard, showing all their muscles and stuff. They looked like they would never be scared. I'm tired, I said, keeping my eyes down on my plate. Had a hard day. A young man like you shouldn't get tired so easy, said Grandma. Man, you're tall for your age and getting broader every day. Seems like you could keep going. Reminds me of myself, said Uncle Ronnie, sprinkling hot sauce on his fish. He never missed a chance to relive his younger days, though. I was handsome, too, and shot up real fast. I spent a couple of years tripping over myself. Troy's lucky, though. He's already got a slide that it took me a few more years to pick up. Everybody always has something to say about my slide. I'm not bragging on myself. It's a fact. My mom used to say she couldn't say no to me when I turned on the charm. It's like a natural gift. Troy may look like you at 13, but let's hope that that's where the resemblance ends, said Pops. He never misses his cue to put Uncle Ronnie down. That's one thing that hadn't changed. And that was Chapter 3 of Riding Trance. We'll get back to our reading on Tuesday, since Monday is a holiday. I hope that everyone has a great weekend. Have a good weekend. Bye-bye.